Hi everyone, this is Lahir from ABCs of Anesthesia, and today we're going to go through vein selection. As a general rule, you can really choose any vein you want. It's just that some veins have certain advantages and other veins have certain challenges. I would always go to the most distal site that still satisfies the purpose. For example, I've got this really long cephalic vein over here. Now, if I was to attempt cannulation here, but I messed up, then you'd get a hematoma here and potentially clot inside the vein. So I wouldn't be able to use all of this segment here for any further cannulation, and that would limit the options for future. Whereas if I went here, even though if I missed, I'd still have each of these other points of insertion. So I'd always say go for the most distal site that still satisfies the purpose. Now there's, broadly speaking, three main areas that you can cannulate on the arm, not counting other parts of the body. Now these areas are the antecubital fossa, the forearm, and the hand. And occasionally I'll also look at the arm as well. Now if I look at the hand, this is one of the most common sites of cannulation. And as you can see in my friend who's very gifted with the amount of veins he has, there's a lot of options with the hand. It's also very easy site to go into. You can get a nice low angle with this site. There's lots of options, and you can get some big veins and some small veins. So it's a very common site to go for. Now the challenges are that often the veins aren't big enough for the really big resuscitation cannulas. And you know, if the patient's in hospital for a few days, they're not gonna be able to use their hand to the full extent because that cannula is gonna probably impede that. Now the forearm is a really great site. Often there's really big veins that you can put really large cannulas for resuscitation into. And it's also very comfortable for the patient. For example, the patient can still move their hand and also move their elbow without blocking the flow of any fluid or medications. And it's kind of an advanced area because you can't always get the low angle that you require to really get those difficult cannulas in. Finally, one of the most common sites for blood taking and cannulation is the antecubital fossa. Now this little spot here is probably one of the first places you'll learn to cannulate, as the veins are superficial and they're quite large. And so it's quite an easy place to start out. Now, those are great reasons to try the cubital fossa, but unfortunately there's also some challenges. There's a lot of structures there, such as nerves, arteries, and tendons that you might accidentally impinge on. And that's something you really want to avoid. For the patient, after being in hospital for a while, they'll be really annoyed by not being able to bend their elbow as well. Bending the elbow with cubital fossa veins means that they might not be able to get the flow of that fluid or the medications that they need. Now, the next thing I want to go through is whether to choose the left or the right hand. And there's a few factors that influence this, including patient preference, the logistics of theater, and also the surgical access. So with a patient, if they're a right-handed patient, I'll generally tend to want to put the cannula in the left hand. That means that their dominant hand, they're able to use freely without too much hassle. I'm always thinking about the logistics of my anesthesia induction. For example, in my theater setup, the anesthesia machine is on the right-hand side of the patient, which means that there's a whole lot of stuff there, including my assistant. Often I'll be standing here at the left-hand side while my trainee or my assistant is doing the airway management. So I want to be able to give medications easily without having to reach over the patient. So left-handed cannula is great depending on your anesthetic setup. Finally, I'm always thinking about surgical access to their case. For example, in lap collies, both arms are out. They're not against the body, they're outwards. And this means that I could really have access and observe where my cannula is for the whole surgery. However, some cases like lap appendectomies, they'll want the left hand in and the right arm out. In that case, I might opt to have the right arm as my cannulation arm. Then there's other procedures like lap gynae surgery where both arms are in. And in that setting, I just leave the cannula in the left arm anyway. So I hope you enjoyed that. Those are all the things that go through my mind when I'm trying to choose a vein. I'm trying to choose which site I'm going to put it in, whether it's the left or right hand. I'm trying to think of the logistics of the theater and my anesthetic induction, and also what the surgical preference will be, and thereby make my decision. What you'll find is that you'll be able to go through these and see certain patterns and trends, and always get your supervisor to assist you in deciding as well. Thanks very much.